of all, I'd like to ask that what was the reason behind the success in a time when we are seeing so many other, you know, companies failing to put up a convincing show at IPOs? IndiaMart really stood out. So what do you think worked for you?
I think there is always a demand for quality companies with quality financials and quality future potential. It's just that when there are too many IPOs happening, you know, there's a little differentiation between quality. In fact, when there's a tougher time, I guess the quality companies, because there are tougher time, they get sold cheap, and they end up doing well. I think both the things happen with us also. And you know, why did we decide to go in such a tough market? Because we were convinced about our numbers. Our numbers were growing. We had a positive EBITDA, margin expansion, 25-30% growth rate. So I think we were quite confident that, you know, come what may, market, I think all numbers would be taken well by investors. We may have to give some discount, but I think that worked much in our favor rather. I actually don't have any opinion, because the word over, whether it is the growth chasing company or whether it is the profitable growth chasing company, all kind of companies are, when it cannot be just one parameter called I am profitable. You know, there are so many parameters by which you recognize the market size of a company, the future potential of a company, the, you know, growth profile, the overall margins can it get to. So I don't think just one parameter. I think in the past there has been more focus on only chasing growth at any cost, which I guess has been moderated a bit, that not at any cost, but you know, at some day you have to become a break even and return the money. So I think there's some sanity has come in, but it's again a demand supply, and how big the opportunity is. Those are the parameters. Very difficult to tell, you know. I think it is very easy to find out why something failed. It is very difficult to tell why something succeeded. I think this is a lot of teamwork at IndiaMart, timing of the thought process. By the time we finally got a product market fit right, how many experiments we had done at IndiaMart. I mean, if you just tell me, if I can put that out in 4 or 5, you know, bullet points, it will be very difficult. But I think, you know, one thing that that every entrepreneur should think of is whether he himself is going to participate in a paradigm shift change, or he himself is going to bring a paradigm shift change. And since the paradigm shifts do take a long period of time, and you may not be the first one to do it right. So I think one, the long-term commitment to keep doing it, keep trying it. And second, I think instead of doing something very incremental, are you trying to yourself do the paradigmical shift, or you are participating in a paradigm shift that is already happening? Those are the few things already very important, and finally you have to get lucky. So IPO supposedly be the beginning of the company, you know, it's called initial public offering. So I would say that as I had a 20-year instant running a private company, now I think next 20 years would be running a public company. So IPO is all about you know, starting up all over again. You know, it is just a milestone in the entire journey. There are so many things to happen, you know. One, now that you are profitable and growing, how to find out better use of deployment of cash, how to you generate more money from there. How do you take advantage of the credibility and the visibility that you get because of the IPO to attract better talent and to attract better customers to be able to provide better services. So there are so many things, you know, we are currently working on fintech opportunities, we are working on SaaS opportunities, we continue to work on more and more categories within IndiaMart, more and more geographies within IndiaMart. Earlier we were mostly known as a small business company, now we work with the small business, medium sized business and even large corporates and multinationals also. So I think there is enough to do in the internet, and you know, because this whole internet and mobile internet brings you a lot of power in your pocket. So there is enough to do and lot more to be discovered in times to come, and India itself is at a juncture where you know, lot of working age population is higher than the, you know, our median age just turned 28 years of old. So I think there is enough to do. There are too many things that you have to practice post getting public listed, and until unless you start to practice them some 2-3 years in advance, I don't think you can overnight convert into a public company.
Yes,
on one day you were not listed and one day you are suddenly listed, but I think you need to start to practice a quarterly practice of putting up board paper, the timeliness in which you want to do, the disclosures that you want to do, and more so, you know, the prediction that you want to do about your business. So I think there are so many things that you need to do, start practicing much before going public.